I'm here to introduce you to another exciting project that we have in the works. We are still in the design stages, but we are getting closer and closer to construction. These are the times that I think projects like these are even more important to share. At a time like now, where a lot of people are on lockdown in their house, self-isolation and quarantine, maybe their travel, whatever it may be, throughout these, you know, unprecedented times, it's that much more important to talk about building and designing healthy homes. Because now, more than ever, we're actually spending even more time in our homes. So yes, I see a lot of people in my neighborhood outside walking, more than I've ever seen before, but now they're actually spending that time in their home as well. And you know, before we were in buildings a lot, but not necessarily in our house. We'd go from our house to our car, to the building that we work in, the grocery store, whatever it may be. But now the majority of that time is in our house. And if our house is not efficient or not healthy, that's going to affect us, not comfortable, for example. So this house is exciting and we're excited to share it.
Because there's a bit of a bump out here. It comes in, even like where I'm standing for now, goes past the well.
But it might make sense for him to just go straight in for 90 meters.
Oh, I see.
And then start, and then we'll measure back, and then we'll do that.
Today we are on site, another custom home we have coming up, another net zero home. And we got a little bit of pressure on us because of the warm weather that we have coming. The city has put the half load restrictions a little bit earlier than we anticipated. And what that did is, if we were to wait, it would have prevented us from getting the machine here by about 2 months. So we are here quickly, made this happen in a few days all of a sudden, just to clear some trees before the birds' nesting season, because that's something that the homeowner was concerned about. So we're here, we're gonna clear trees for the driveway and the area where the septic in the house is gonna go. Not too much, you know, just enough to make give us enough space to get an idea of what the lot's gonna be and make sure that what we've designed is actually gonna work well on this lot. So we've trekked through the snow, which was deeper than anticipated. Did not bring my big boots for that. And the guys are marking out about 10 meters off the lot line. And we're gonna head back about 90 meters and then work our way back on where the house and the septic area is going to be.
Our site planning process for this particular project really spent a lot of time dealing with the existing vegetation. We're working on a lot that is quite heavily treed. About one third of the lot, the trees are quite mature, some of which are probably over 75 years old. On the front two thirds of the site, however, we're working on an area that probably as recently as 30 or 40 years ago was a farmer's field. And so although it is densely vegetated, there are not as many mature specimens that we are working to avoid. The clients were really quite interested in ensuring that views from their primary spaces are ones of their own rear yard and of their own mature trees and not views of the neighboring constructions. You know, we've taken care to preserve a visual screen, a vegetated buffer, not only you know in the front 30 meters or so of the lot, but also along both side lot lines to a depth of about 10 meters. And we expect that once construction is finished, we'll need to supplement some of the existing vegetation with strategically planted new vegetation.
Some of the features that we're working on and we're designing in right now, as we work with Chris Straka of Vert Design, who also did my passive home about 6 years ago, and we've become good friends since, is working on this. So this is gonna be about 3,200 square feet, no basement, doesn't make sense. They didn't really need the basement, doesn't make sense for the lot either. There's gonna be a workshop, there's gonna be a media room for things like virtual reality. There's going to be four bedrooms, and one of those is a guest suite, so have a little kitchenette in it, its own separate bathroom. There's gonna be 3.5 bathrooms in total. Since there's no basement, There will be some storage above the garage, so like attic storage, unconditioned space. The home will be fossil fuel free. You know, we're going actually net zero, and we're not just trying to offset that carbon. We're actually looking to get rid of that completely. So this will be fossil fuel free. And there'll be a screened in exterior area, which will be important for this lot because there will be lots of mosquitoes there. Right now, we're also discussing a greenhouse and potentially some rainwater collection, but we're in the process of figuring out whether or not that makes sense for this lot, and you know, seeing how it's on well as well. And also discussing a solar heated pool. You know, one of the things that I believe in personally is that there is, you know, for a house to be truly sustainable, we have to feel like we are not sacrificing anything. If we feel like we're sacrificing something, we won't sustain it, right? If we're giving up on something that we really want, chances are we're not going to continue it, right? So we need to replace that with something or figure out a good way to do it. So pools, you know, can be done. It doesn't have to be heated off of propane or natural gas, whatever. It doesn't even have to be heated at all, right? So things like that, you know, you don't have to compromise, right? We don't want to compromise on anything. We just want to make it better. We want to improve it. I think that's important, not just for building houses, but for everything we do in life. And that's what we've been working towards with this couple. So that's why we're excited to share this. It's going to be a beautiful home. We haven't got into the nitty gritty details of design and finishes and so forth, but you know, obviously we're leaning towards healthier indoor air quality. So, you know, there's going to be a fresh air system. And because I mentioned there's no fossil fuels, it's going to be likely an air source heat pump to heat the home and cool the home. Same technology. And you know, triple glazed windows. You know, we're implementing some of these passive house standards, but we're not going to get passive house certification necessarily. We're going to get the net zero certification. So I really hope that you follow us along this journey, which we've already started by subscribing to the channel, and we'll continuously update you on this project as well as the 3-day cottage that we're going to be building, which is another net zero building, and all of the other exciting things that we have on the go. So I hope you're staying healthy, be well, and we will see you on the next episode.